today, a special on the little lady who started the Great Civil War, the insightful author, active abolitionist, and the influence on her entire generation, Harriet Beecher Stowe.
Harriet Elizabeth Beecher was born in Litchfield, Connecticut on June 4, 1811. Her father was a minister in a Protestant church. He preached anti-slavery, especially in 1820 because of the recent controversy of Missouri becoming a slave state. Her mother was always interested in education. She set an example to value education for all of her children. She died when Harriet was only 5 years old.
Mr. Lyman Beecher encouraged intellectual family debates at the dinner table. Harriet often proved herself very bright by winning lots of these debates. Mr. Beecher often expressed that he wished Harriet was a boy because she would have had better opportunities to use her influential intellectual potential.
However, Mr. Beecher didn't realize that Harriet would go on to have the greatest impact on the country, despite the fact that she was born female. Harriet's father relocated the family to Cincinnati, Ohio, after accepting a job as the president of Blaine Theological Seminary. It was there that Harriet met and married Calvin Stowe, a professor at Blaine.
The geographical location of Cincinnati played a large role in inspiring Harriet Beecher Stowe to write her most famous novel, Uncle Tom's Cabin. As you can see, Cincinnati is located on the border between Kentucky and Ohio. Kentucky at the time was a slave state. Harriet got first-hand experience when she and her husband discovered that their household servant, Scylla, was a runaway slave. The couple helped her to the next Underground Railroad station. Her newfound proximity to the world of slavery, along with the passing of the Fugitive Slave Act in 1850, motivated her to write an abolitionist novel about a good Christian slave, Uncle Tom, who is killed by his cruel master, Simon Legree.
As well as her mother and father, Harriet was influenced by the abolitionist author, Theodore Wells.
I love this book and its ideas. I'm so inspired, I think I'm going to write my own abolitionist book.
Wells was a reformer and abolitionist. His wife, sister-in-law, and himself collectively put together the book called American Slavery as It Is, A Testimony of 1,000 Witnesses. This book illustrated how the slaves ate, their work hours, their rest hours, their clothing, their housing, their hardships and suffering. It was designed to show the horror of slavery through the voices of free men and whites. It was extremely influential.
Inspired by Harriet's father and Theodore Wells' book, Harriet became an abolitionist. From the influence of her mother, Harriet became an education professional. She attended and later taught at the Hartford Female Seminary, a school founded by her sister Catherine. They taught innovative subjects such as physical education and home economics.
The death of her son Charlie at 18 months from cholera, Harriet was able to empathize with slave mothers who often had their children ripped from their arms.
My son has gone to Jesus!
Harriet Elizabeth Beecher Stowe died on July 1st, 1896. During her 51-year writing career, she wrote 30 novels and many other shorter works. Through her writing, she spread abolitionist sentiment around the country and also promoted women's rights. Harriet's most famous novel, Uncle Tom's Cabin, gave her lasting fame and support for the cause. It has sold millions of copies worldwide and has been translated into over 60 different languages. It is considered to be one of the most important books of the 19th century. Because of her active involvement in spreading the abolitionist feeling, she is often credited with taking part in causing the Civil War. Harriet left her mark on the world by rapidly gaining support for it and spreading the idea of abolitionism.
Thank you. that started this great war.
That's right!
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind,